Welcome to Morning Glory Farmstead. My name is Lolly, and this channel is all about gardening, animals, and nature. It's playtime, and they never stop trying to catch up with Donka. It is not gonna happen. These critters around here are terrified of me. Look how fast he's running away like lightning. Snugs is enjoying the catio and the sun. And y'all, look at that tree swallow. I showed you guys the eastern bluebird babies. I've shown you guys the chickadee babies. And now we've got some tree swallows that are building a nest in this box. Now, last year, they built a nest in the same type of box in the backyard, but there's another set of eastern bluebirds in that box already. So this is the only box I have left that's empty. I think I've got 6 or 7 birdhouses around here. And I have at least 5 of this particular style because it's really good for so many different types of birds. Now, because of where I have the camera right here in the shade, you can't see their color very good. You just kind of see the silhouette, but they are a beautiful blue, especially the males. They have a beautiful blue and some white on their chest, and they flutter around all over the yard, just like bats almost. And so if you see these out in the evening, you might tend to think it's a bat and not a tree swallow. You got to know your birds, but I absolutely adore them. I never get tired of those little pink flowers or the white ones. And all of those rosebuds that I've been showing you guys have all bloomed. They look very beautiful right now. And look at the blueberries. Y'all, I cannot wait. It's gonna be me and the mockingbirds duking it out. In one of my videos from last summer, I believe, I was talking about how the mockingbirds would actually swoop down and peck the back of my head gently every time I took a blueberry off the bush because they were eating them too and didn't want me to eat them all. Hey, for those of you who are not aware, GreenStalk is having their Mother's Day sale right now, and it's gonna run through May 15th. It's on their 5-tier original vertical planter, which is $114.97 right now, and the 7-tier leaf vertical planter is $124.97. So y'all check that out, go to the description box, and you can use my code and my link to get an additional 10 bucks off that sale price. Just a quick peek at the grow bag so you can see the progress. You know, I've got the greens, I've got the honeysuckle, I've got 4 o'clock growing in here, and all of it's looking really good right now. In 3 of the bags, none of the seeds germinated because they were some really old seeds that someone gave to me, just kind of experiment and see if they would grow, and they were flowers. But I think I'm gonna take those 3 grow bags and just make sure the potting mix is looking really good and plant something else. All right, let's do a quick run through of the green stalks. You can see the greens on the left are doing really well. That's just a variety of greens. Here we've got the hum butter for the hummingbirds and the butterflies. These are looking good too. Can't wait to see something start blooming out of there. Here's some strawberries. Y'all know I've had a problem with mice or something eating these. If they're dangling on the side like that, I can eat them. And if they're still not very red and I can snag it, then I can eat it. But they're eating the ones that have any red on them at all. These strawberries don't get big. They're pretty small, but the flavor is super intense and hands down are better than anything I've ever had at the store, even when they're not ripe. Here are the larger variety of tomatoes. Okay, so they're all doing pretty well. And as I've said before, if there's any pockets where things have not germinated, I'm going to plant something else really soon, and that'll just be like succession planting. So no big deal. I'll just have some that come up a little bit later. Here's my smaller cherry tomato varieties. They're looking good. Coming up faster than the larger varieties. Y'all, don't forget to turn your green stalks. I actually turn mine twice a day when the heat is intense. You know, as we get into those summer days where we're breaking all kinds of records and everything, I will turn it at least twice a day just to keep it from scorching. And also, don't forget to make sure you water it, and it's best in the morning or the evening if you can do that. And you know, even if you're using the watering system, pay attention to your plants. They will let you know if they need more water. So the watering system is good to disperse the water for you, but you still need to keep an eye on your plants because we have such extreme heat. Here's the bean stalk, or the bean machine. Y'all, I cannot come up with a name for these green stalks. I gotta figure something out. There's a couple pockets in this green stalk that definitely need something else planted because nothing ever came up. So I'll just do some more beans in this one. I mentioned in the last video that I had about 11 green stalk tiers that were still going to seed, and I'm just kind of waiting, but I actually have 17, which is why stuff is such a mess around the edges of the patio, and I really can't get to it yet to finish. I've got to put more dirt, more pavers around the patio and stuff like that, but right now I just have a lot of tiers sitting around. Y'all, this railing planter scene is about to get busy all over again. If y'all watched the last video, you saw all I went through to get the dirt in those railing planters behind me, but now we're backtracking today. I really need to get these secured down so they don't fall off. They're too big because they're made to fit like 4 to 5 inches, and I think my railings are about 3.5 inches. So I went ahead and put the potting mix in, thinking I could secure it underneath and just kind of wedge something underneath the railing planters, but that doesn't seem like that's going to be the best choice. So after thinking about it, I decided to go ahead with what the viewer suggested, and that was zip ties. Y'all, I use zip ties for everything, and I was thinking I could put some holes in it and use some wire, but for some reason zip ties didn't cross my mind, and I use those for everything. And Dad goes, yeah, I thought about zip ties too, but he never mentioned it. So now we're going to take everything out, we're going to put some holes, and then put the dirt back in and be done. So what's going to happen is the grandkids are coming over, and we're going to work on one railing planter at a time. So we'll dump it out. I'm going to use the soldering kit again to put some holes in it. I'll zip tie it, and then we'll put the dirt back in again. And then after we get that done, I'm going to plant some potatoes in some grow bags and do some experimenting, because honestly, these potatoes are pretty far gone. I think most people probably wouldn't plant them, but I'm going to anyway. So we'll talk about that in a few minutes. Now, I'm thinking the easiest thing to do here would be do one at a time. So take this out, put it in there, which is what I used last time. And as soon as we're done putting the holes and doing the zip ties, then we can just dump that dirt straight back in here. So I don't really have to divvy it up. I already know it's going to fit and how much it needs. Then we can plant. All right, so I've got my helpers here, and I'm kind of just guiding them on what we're gonna do. I'm gonna show them how to put holes in the planters, and then I'm gonna let them each have a turn. You guys have seen how easy it is in my last video when it comes to using the soldering iron, and so basically we're putting 4 holes in each planter just so we can put the zip ties through. They're always coming over because Grammy's got projects going on all the time. So it just kind of gives them some things to do. They have good teamwork. They get along well while they're doing it. And they're always learning something new. It's super fun. So this is what they look like, and we'll just clip those zip ties. Now, it's definitely not really sturdy, but it's not falling off. I jerked on it pretty hard, so it's not going to tip over and just fall off like it did before. And with the dirt in there, it's going to make it a lot heavier. So I've already put all of my labels in there so that I know exactly what's going in which planter, and I will show you that in a minute. I'm also going to share with you the seeds that I'm planting just so that you can see the difference in the seeds. All right, first up, we've got some oregano, and they are so tiny. Now, all I'm doing is using my fingers. These are supposed to be 1/4 of an inch underneath the potting mix, and so there's really no need for any kind of tools, and then I'm just kind of moving the dirt around to cover them. These are caraway seeds. They look completely different than the oregano. That's why I find it so interesting. All right, here we've got sweet basil. This mockingbird is a few feet over to the right, protecting his territory. All right, this is a lettuce. It looks like rouge de hiver, and I know that's not how you say it. These are Landis winter lettuce. That's much easier to say. This is the Rocky Top lettuce blend, and it's actually pretty easy to identify because the seeds are different colors. I like that one. Now, I don't know if I'm saying this right either, but it looks like Troncuta kale. We'll just stick with kale. All right, enough of that. Let me just show you what I got going on here. All right, so for the potato experiment, I'm gonna use some grow bags that I have, and I'm gonna use some topsoil and compost that I have, and I'm not gonna hill, I'm not gonna chit, I'm just gonna put these whole potatoes down in there and see what happens. All right, I'm gonna use black cow manure, and then it's organic, and I'm also gonna use the topsoil that I've been using in a lot of my other stuff. Now, I don't know how this is gonna go because I don't think the black cow is gonna be very sandy and loose and exactly what potatoes like, but I'm gonna use what I have. And these are 2 20-gallon bags. I had already changed my mind that quick between the time when I recorded what I was gonna do and when I got back here. I think I'm gonna use one potato, and then I've already cut one up into 5 pieces and I'm gonna use those. Now I'm not gonna hill. I am just gonna bury them deep enough. But I did chit, and I am doing one whole one. I decided this is gonna be a lot of work, and it would be a lot of work to do one potato in a whole 20-gallon bag, and that's it, and then just stop. So I wanna do more. Now, you guys may be thinking one potato in that bag, but I had seen a few different videos of people doing potatoes, and granted, this isn't exactly the right medium for it, but they said if you do a whole potato, you can get a lot of potatoes from that one. I'm just gonna see what it does. I'm not really worried about using up the whole bag. I've got plenty of bags. What I am concerned about is that this black cow is like a hard rectangle, and it's gonna be a lot of work to get it broken up, you guys. Y'all, I have to laugh because every time I start to do a project for my videos, and it's something I would do anyway, I'm just sharing it, but I always tell you what I'm going to do because that's part of my training history, right? You tell them what you're going to do and then you do it. But every time I tell you, I go back and think, why did I tell them I was going to do that? Because it's always 1,000 times harder than what I predict. Like this, I didn't know I was going to be in a wrestling match with cow manure today. I mean, the bag is open and I couldn't even get it to come out. I'm gonna have to be working on this a long time, y'all. I'm not sure how good this video footage is gonna be, and you know I've got to be careful or I'm gonna get sick. Oh my gosh. You can see here what it looks like. It is super hard, and I'm gonna have to take a shovel and pound it. I'm actually using my pooper scooper for the dogs because it's smaller and I can control it better. And I think that's appropriate for this particular one of pounding up this cow manure. Y'all, but one thing I can say is I do not like these flimsy grow bags that are always in the way. So not only do I have to do all this manual labor of breaking up this stuff, which is super hard, I gotta fight with bags too. All right, so I did one layer of that. Now I'm gonna do a layer of the topsoil. Then I'm gonna do another layer of the composted manure, and then one more layer of topsoil. And I'm gonna be mixing it all up. Y'all know how much I love that. I really hope this doesn't produce diseased tubers. I hope they do okay. You can tell I'm actually mixing it up because that lighter brown color is the composted manure. Y'all, I could have just recorded my facial expressions going on right now. That would have said it all. All right, it's time to use my hands and get down in there and make sure it's really mixed up good. Y'all, some people go to the spa or the nail salon to get their hands and nails done. This is what I do. Surely there is some kind of health benefit from putting my hands in all this composted manure. I'm gonna dig a hole now and just put that one potato in this whole bag and see what happens. So I want to go ahead and bury it in here before I put any more and fill up this bag. I decided to uncover it and pull it up just a little bit more so it's not so near the bottom of the bag. Make sure it's got enough room underneath and on top. Let me just say, I take my hat off and I have a newfound respect for potting mix and soils that you don't have to break up with a shovel. You guys, that took me so long to do that I am not about to record the next part. I just need to get it done because it's already evening time and I'm racing against the clock because I got to get my chickens and my dogs and cats taken care of. But I'll just show you, I buried 5 pieces of potato like this one I'm showing you here, and I'm gonna do the very same thing in this other bag. And Dad went and got me some more straw because I didn't have enough, and I'm gonna use that to mulch the top. Well, they look like they could use a good trim or a haircut, but you know what? They're done. Woohoo! All right, y'all, thanks for hanging out with me today during my family fun and potato shenanigans. I'll see you real soon in the next video. And until then, y'all have a great couple of days. Bye-bye.